Our stories used to be so simple. We had a beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you. Snow. I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once, and...
I'm not yours to lose. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
She looks like Holly.
It's not Holly. It's her sister, Lily.
She was hooking to pay down debt. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club, the pudding and pie.
My name is Narissa.
Well, Narissa, I've got some questions. The open arms.
Oh my God! What is it?
It's Crane. Motherfucking piece of shit!
Crane? Ugh, God, you think you'd know a person. Bigby, you have to tell her.
I know!
What's going on? What did you find up there?
Crane's the killer.
What? Ichabod Crane? How do you know?
Shit!
Crane's been... Oh, Bigby, calm down. Everything's going to be fine. Okay, it's going to be fine.
Perverted little fucker might be after Snow. I need to find her right now.
Okay, it's going to be okay. Where did you see her last? Did she say where she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
Yeah.
How do you know?
I was just at the Trip Trap, and I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham Bridge.
Trip Trap? Are you drinking?
When?
Right now. They were on their way out.
Bigby! Wait!
What?
Snow's been through a lot. There are things she doesn't talk about. Just please be careful.
What are you trying to say?
You know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
People she trusted and cared for. I won't, offend you by claiming one day that the pain of losing Lily will ever subside. How she could be stubborn and patient.
I'll miss worrying
rash
about
and
you.
Thoughtful.
I'll miss our
how she
fights.
Carried a torch for the
I'll
old
miss
ways.
You.
For tradition.
Holly.
For, pageantry. And most of all, it seems how...
Now you
Lily
will never die from indifference
or
lead a tedious life. Goodbye,
she
sweetheart.
Being around them.
Thanks for
good
everything.
Good times and bad.
Vivian.
I never met Lily, but from what I've been told, I know in my heart
you
that
are
she
a big,
would have liked
bright,
to be
shining star
and
in
now
this
we'll
shithole of a town.
Moment of silence.
And I miss you already.
Thank you.
Gren.
Is everything okay?
No, not you.
Holly, it's...
He wasn't fucking invited.
Holly, wait.
He has no right to be here. Not after what he did.
Holly, I'm sorry, but I had to come.
You throw my sister down the witching well, and you have the nerve to show your face here?
After you lie? After you promise me?
Holly, wait. That was Crane. Just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything about it. I'm telling you the truth.
Don't cover for him.
But this genuinely wasn't his fault.
You can't tell me Bigby gives a shit about this.
Crane's a fucking prick, so this doesn't surprise me.
Hey, what do you know? We actually agree on something.
Bigby cares, Holly. He's trying to help. And I'm sure he has a very good reason for being here. But this one isn't on him.
Why are you here, anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Everything okay?
I'm here to talk to Snow.
Oh, really?
Yes, Holly. This is serious.
Okay, look. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat far away from the ceremony, all right? Look, Holly, I know how this must...
No, you don't know how this must feel. You have no idea. Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody. And when the first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here. You hear me?
I just want to get Lily's killer, Holly. Nothing more.
Let's just continue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
Let's go, Holly.
It's your turn to talk.
This better be wildly important. It's been hard enough making a connection with these people.
Crane murdered Lily.
What?
I followed a lead to this shithole motel, the Open Arms. Crane had a room there, and he's been taking prostitutes, or at the very least Lily, and making her look like you while he was, you know. The bed was covered in blood. I know it was him.
This is... I don't even know what to say right now. I really don't. I'm just trying everything I can right now to not picture it.
I'm sorry, Snow. And I'm sorry I had to be the one to tell you.
You're sure this is what happened? This is what he's been doing? Because please, Bigby, don't confuse things.
Crane has been taking photos, Snow. Lots of photos.
Photos that show him...
He's been... recording his visits with Lily.
God. Look, let's go back to the business office. I doubt Crane's there at this hour, but we need to talk. And this isn't the place.
Snow?
Narissa? What is it?
I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you.
Are they starting the burn?
Yes. Everyone who spoke should really be present for this part. She's kind of distraught. You're not leaving yet, are you?
2 minutes. I don't mean to be,
No, I understand.
No, I get it. Take your time.
It won't take long.
How'd it go? At the motel? Did you find anything? No?
It was Crane's room. But you knew that already, right?
Narissa!
Yeah, coming!
Constable? Wait, easy now, girl. You know how this goes. The first thing in a visit, you say, how do you do? How do you do?
Now is really not the time for whatever you jagoffs are planning to do.
Well, isn't that the thing of it? Plans. Except it isn't our plans you should be concerning yourself with. I'm still hurting, you know, from our talk in the cell. And I'll be honest, I'd love nothing more than to carve a sweet poem right into your face for the suffering you've caused me. But I am a professional, and we're here for a job. We'll snip to the chase for all sakes. A little bird told us that you're fitting to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular boy. So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone. Just take a little vacation is all. Don't even have to go anywhere. just sit in your office and whistle to heaven for a few short days.
You have 3 seconds to fuck off before this goes to a place you don't want it to.
Oh, I don't have my stopwatch on me. So what's it gonna be? We have a deal? You leave Crane alone, and we leave you to yours?
You think this act you got going scares me? 'Cause it doesn't.
Always wanting to do things the fun way.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not...
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose, but we only had a deal to work out with Bigby. And we're unhappy to report that things did not go as smoothly as planned.
Bigby, what is he talking about?
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
What deal? I'm not making any deal with you. So just get the fuck out of here and leave these people alone.
Nah.
What did I tell you? What did I say?
Ollie?
Think you motherfuckers could come here uninvited? You think you could just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
Calm down, darling. It's just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Holly, don't move.
Holly, let me handle this.
Yeah, let's spare all the fuss. It's just a dead hole.
I'm gonna kill you!
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're gonna be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy. Don't go looking for any more fights. Keep strain off your heart.
I can't take it easy. I have to find Crane.
Bigby? What's wrong?
Lack of sleep for one thing. Getting shot for another. He'll be fine. I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived. So I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper and spring water. Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do. Everything in moderation. And eat more chicken. Your blood pressure's through the proverbial roof.
I'll try to.
All right then. Very good.
Business office. I know. I'll have to call you back. The town is starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it then. Miss White? Bigby?
So, to recap...
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after him. And We know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane. So, I guess that's the plan, currently. But I don't know.
There's no other leads. This is it. Just wait for the mirror.
Yeah. What the hell is going on? I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this. I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him. I get it, but do you really think he killed those women? Because it's just... it's incomprehensible to me.
I'm as confused as you are, to be honest. I don't know. It just doesn't make sense.
He was a conniver, a coward, a liar. And I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts. But murdering prostitutes?
Ow!
Everything okay over there?
Yes, Miss White. Just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
Thanks for tonight, by the way. That could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did.
I just feel bad for Holly, really.
Yeah. Time heals everything eventually. At least, I hope so, for her sake. Can I, ask you a question? It's kind of personal. And I don't want to offend you, but after tonight, it's on my mind.
Sure.
It's just, when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe in some tiny little bottled up way deep inside, you kind of enjoy it when things go wrong. Because it gives you an excuse to just, you know, stop pretending.
Why even bring this up?
I guess it doesn't matter.
Guys? We have a problem.
What is it?
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
Yes, it's,
Crane must have taken a shard with him.
Oh, I can't believe this.
I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
Well, the mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Bufkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take. We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
No.
What exactly is the hard way?
We'll look through his things, his desk, everything. He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror. We can still solve this ourselves. I know
never
that
Never mind that. Come help me look.
There's a page here that was torn out.
Oh, yeah? Bufkin, do you know what was here?
It's a ring, at least. Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in Fable Town. It must be this witch he is going to see.
Wait, what? What witch? What meeting?
He called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that, whoever that is. Well, yes, it sounded like the one he got his, glamours from. I'm sure it's about this ring. They must have it.
Why not mention this before?
No one asked me.
Bufkin!
And I'm hungover. I'm sorry. He set the meeting at 2 a.m. tonight.
What's going on? Is the mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard, this isn't the time.
Is the mirror fixed or isn't it? You called me to...
I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag. So, can we find the dull pervert or not?
Bluebeard, get the hell out of here. This is none of your business.
None of my business? Crane's the murderer. He escaped. It seems he's foiled your every attempt at locating him. And now it's none of my business?
We don't know if he's the murderer.
Oh, please. Of course he is.
Look, this just isn't the time. He took a piece of the mirror, so we can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
A.M. or P.M.?
A.M.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to turn away help.
Why do you even care about this?
Why? I'm invested in this enterprise we call Fable Town. Literally invested, since it's mostly my money that keeps the whole thing running. And tonight I hear that Crane has been killing fables? And there's no system in place to catch him?
Look, we know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. I mean, who put you in charge in the first place?
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
thing.
You're
a secretary. He's the sheriff. And none of you are chosen to run this office. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that
Who
doesn't...
Who elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years.
Snow can obviously handle this, so let's drop it.
Well then, excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
All right, let's just look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
And that he'll be there at 2. So that gives us a few short hours to find out who it is and where they live and get them all at once.
And a few shorter hours the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
2 a.m. Piece of cake.
Since Lily used the glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet. It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the two Tweedles know about this?
It doesn't matter what they know. After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not smart enough to try and go anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down.
If Holly has Lily's things, that'd probably be the safer bet.
I don't really care what you two do. I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't just go up there.
And why the hell not?
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock! I've wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him. I won't waste any more.
You just can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh, now it's evidence.
Bluebeard, just stay out of it, all right? You'll just mess things up further.
I can't get any more messed up.
We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions. Look, this is how a smart person would do it. So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
I don't like you going anywhere unsupervised. He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it now. Where are you gonna go, Bigby?
So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.
Dee and Dumb must know where he is. I should go to their office first.
Perfect. And I'll go to Crane's apartment.
I'll look up their address. I hope you know what you're doing.
Excuse me.
Oh, hi. Sheriff Bigby. Great to see you. I don't know if you remember me. I've, seen you around, but you may have forgotten.
I know who you are, Flycatcher. You've worked at the Woodlands for how many years now?
I think I've lost count. But you know, Crane, let me go recently.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I mean, it's no big deal. So, what brings you here? I mean, can I help you with anything? Are you here to see one of the brothers?
I was hoping to have a talk with Dee or Dumb. Do you know where they are?
No, they don't really keep regular hours as far as I can tell. Sorry. It's been a quiet night so far. I think the twins are out, probably working on a case. Sometimes I don't see them for days. They gave me the job after Crane told me to get lost. He said I was just in the way.
Flycatcher, I'm in a hurry.
Oh, sorry. I was just gonna clean their office next. I can let you in if you want. You can wait for them there.
Sure. Thanks.
No problem.
I'm gonna have to take a look around.
Well, I guess that would be okay.
I wasn't really asking for permission.
Right. You're the sheriff. I just don't want to get in trouble or anything. I'm sure it's fine. I mean, they never told me not to let you in.
Don't worry. I won't get you in trouble, all right?
Right.
Dear Brother Dumb, I hate dogs and you know it. Sincerely, Brother D. What's that about?
They do have their quirks.
Dear Brother D, I think we should get ourselves a dog. Sincerely, Brother Dumb. Couple of freaks. This is pointless.
I know these guys can come off abrasive at times, but they aren't so bad once you get to know them. And they really care about helping people. They're kind of loud at times, but you get used to it.
How do you mean they help people?
They're detectives. Anyone can come in here with a problem and they'll do their best to fix it. The way Dee explains it, it's like if someone lost their cat, well, they could hire them to, you know, track it down. Or like sometimes they get packages for people. They can be like couriers, you know?
For who?
All kinds. Come to think of it, I don't really know where they keep them. Anyways, I'm just saying, you just don't know them like I do.
Sure, Flycatcher. You know about this?
No.
Let's see if they've got a file on a Crane. This is worse than I thought. Shit. Detective Brannigan. Keep an eye on her. Ichabod Crane. He owes the crooked man money. Shit. How is he planning to pay this all back? Request for property acquisition. Further details filed under donkey skin. Crane hired them to look for a photo? Why did he want it back so badly? So that's why they were at her apartment. And the woodsman's place.
See, I knew you wouldn't find anything. Anything of interest, anyways. They're detectives, like I said. Just trying to make an honest living. See?
I haven't found anything yet.
I'm just saying.
Look, just trust me on this. Tweedledee and Dumb are not nice. They're not helping anyone.
Well, they helped me.
Okay, great. They helped you. That's one person. Now, please, just let me concentrate here.
Find anything?
Not what I need.
What if you're wrong about them?
I'm not.
They're misunderstood, sure, but that doesn't mean everything people say about them is true. I mean, you know, like when I think about it, you guys aren't that different. You help people, and they help people, Not that it's any of my business, but I just wanted to say, you know, give him a chance.
Let's get one thing straight. They are nothing like me.
Bigby?
Shit. There's something here. I know there is. There has to be.
Why would there be anything
Because they're lying to you, okay, Flycatcher? That's why. They aren't detectives. They're hired guns. Hitmen.
Bigby, what happened to your...
You want to know what this is? This is them showing up to Lily's funeral with fucking shotguns!
I'm sorry, I didn't know.
Holly and Gren both got injured. Snow White nearly got her head blown off. Do you get it now?
I didn't mean to...
There's a door behind this file cabinet. I don't know what they keep back here, but it might be what you're looking for. Well, that key you found should work.
For BCW.
What are you looking for exactly? Maybe I can help.
Anything about Crane. Or the witch he was using. Something. Crooked Man? For your collection.
What is that?
No idea. Pretty sure it's something they aren't supposed to have. This isn't the witch, though. J.D. A book. This doesn't really tell us much. I'm sorry, I know I'm late. I'll get it to you soon. Ichabod Crane.
Who was he sending money to?
Crooked Man. Care of the Lucky Pawn. You know what that is?
Is that what you needed?
I don't think so, but it's interesting. There's more going on here. I still need to find that witch, though. Butcher? What is this stuff?
Hey, Bigby. Do you think, after all this, do you think I could come back to the Woodlands? Since Crane let me go, I mean, I can still work here, but I don't think I want to now. I don't want to work with bad people, you know? You and Snow, you're nice.
Well, Crane is gone now. I can't see why he couldn't come back to the Woodlands.
Really? That would be... Thank you.
Come by the business office. I can't make any promises.
Right, of course.
It's Snow's hair.
Snow White? Why?
We found her hair like this inside Lily's glamour. Anti-Greenleaf. This must be the witch Crane was using.
I guess Dee and Dumb were getting the hair for Crane and sending it to her? That's not a pleasant thought.
There's no address on it.
So what now? Snow would probably want to know about this.
I should tell Snow about this. She might need to change her locks.
Well, I can take care of that, if you want.
Maybe she can find a record on this antique Greenleaf.
I think I saw a phone near the back.
Thanks.
You're welcome, Sheriff.
Business office, this is Snow White.
Hey, Snow.
Oh, it's you. Sorry, I've been answering angry phone calls for hours. People want to know who Crane is. How'd it go with the Tweedle brothers?
No address yet, but I got a name for Crane's witch, Auntie Greenleaf. You heard of her?
No. I'll get Bufkin started looking for a record, but it might take some time.
Huh. Somebody's gotta know where to find her. And Snow, I found a note with some money attached. Crane has been embezzling from Fabled Town.
Of course, because why half-ass being a complete sleazeball? Do you think this is tied to the murders? I mean, I guess it doesn't matter yet.
I think it's connected. Maybe the girls found out about it? I don't know.
Maybe. You might want to try Holly's place, see if she hasn't burned Lily's things yet. Or Crane's, you might find something there. Although, Bluebeard's been there. I'll leave it up to you, but we don't have much time. Crane is meeting her at 2 a.m.
I'll go to the Trip Trap, see about Lily's things. I think that's our best option.
Sounds good. Just be gentle with Holly when you get there, okay? I'll give Bufkin the name and hope he finds something in the records.
Let me know what he comes up with.
I'll be in touch. I hope you'll do the same.
We'll catch him, Snow.
Bigby, I have to go. Someone just came in. Good luck.
She's asleep, you fucking idiot.
You didn't even give me a chance to explain. What's left to explain? Just...
We're closed.
Guys, it's me, Bigby. Hey, look, Woody, it's the sheriff. Well, come on in, buddy.
Brent.
What? He's a traveler. A weary traveler in search of some hospitality, right? Just what in the fuck is wrong with you? Nothing's wrong with me. In fact, I'm in a good goddamn mood, so you should take advantage. I want a drink. Anybody else want a drink?
Brent, Swinehart said you shouldn't mix
you
it.
You think I give a fuck what that fucking guy says? Or what you say?
Brent, really, you shouldn't drink right now.
I can't hear you when you mumble.
Swinehart told me that Holly was here. I need to talk to her. Holly's asleep in back, but you won't be able to wake her.
Really?
The doc gave him both barmesidal ambrosia for the pain.
Look, the deal is, if you resist going to sleep, like I am right now, it gives you a very, very, very nice high.
And he said that he shouldn't mix it with alcohol.
Yes, he did. He certainly did. But let me tell you something. I haven't felt this good in a long time, fat boy.
I'm after Crane, all right? The guy we all hate? And there's a time limit here, so try and focus for a minute.
Crane? We'll get to whatever you're here for in a sec. That funeral back there? That was a shitty fucking send-off for a pretty okay lady.
Yeah.
You weren't fucking there. Talking to Bigby now, okay? Can't say you being there helped things much.
Gren, don't start nothing.
Who's starting anything?
You think I shot up the place? It wasn't my fault.
They got away, though, didn't they? Whatever. It's all right. I'm too out of it to get into it. I want to clear the air. We're all in this dung heap of a fucking shit town together. We're all gonna have a toast. All of us.
Fellas, I'm here for one thing. To look through Lily's belongings and get out of here.
Now, yeah, I know. And I want to help you, okay?
And I will. But first, indulge me. It'll take 2 seconds. As a show of good faith. And after, we'll all hunt and peck for Lily's shit or whatever.
Grand Bigby didn't come here to get loaded with you.
I don't want to get loaded with him. It's just a quick slug. Not gonna hurt anybody. And then we'll, you know, help you out with your thing. To the dead.
All right, now help me.
Gren, the doc said you needed a rest.
How many times you fucking gonna warn me about it, huh? You're not my fucking mother, so just get off my back!
I said I was sorry, all right? I can't do anything about it, it's done! What more do you want? What else can I fucking say here?
What is the problem here? What stupid shit will you both not let go of?
Oh, I forgot. You haven't heard the news. This walking lard cake was paying Holly's sister to let him fuck her behind all of our backs. And Holly had to find out going through all of her sister's shit. What fun that must have been. Trick after trick of this fat ass and Lily.
I didn't plan for that, all right? And our thing, whatever it wasn't a big deal. It wasn't. I never fucked her when she was snowing. I didn't know nothing about that.
No, but you knew Holly would flip out. And you knew for a damn good fucking reason.
You know what? Fuck this. I don't need this shit.
Oh yeah, that's it. Now you're teary-eyed. You were always such a lowlife. I don't know why I never realized it till now. What do you think about this fucking loser, Sheriff?
He can think whatever he wants. I don't give a shit.
No, that's okay, because I'll tell you what he thinks.
I think whatever happened was between them, and Lily is dead. So let's put this whole thing to rest, Gren.
Gren, I don't know where Lily's shit is. Check Holly's room, I don't know. But I wouldn't wake her if I were you. Sleepwalkers and trolls. I think that's the rule.
I thought you said you would help me look.
Actually, Bigby, if you'll excuse me, it seems that I'm gonna pass out. What a day. Am I right, Sheriff? What a fucking day.
Bar's closed, and Lily ain't around anyway, so you can run off back to the woods, I guess. Did you care about her at all? She was a nice girl. Ran around too much, but a nice girl. I thought you were a friend. I don't know why you fucking came here. There's nothing left for you to ruin. And I'm not in an entertaining mood. Lily's funeral. It was just so fucked tonight. I just don't know what Bigby's doing. If he cares about it. If he even gives a shit. I don't know. I don't know why he showed up.
He cares about this. About Lily. About Faith. I know he does.
You think so?
Yeah.
Well, you know him better than anybody, so... I guess I'll take your word for it.
If you were getting your glamour on this day, then one of these has to be the witch. Auntie Greenleaf. Gotcha.
Hello, this is Snow White calling. I'm looking for Bigby. Is anyone there? Bigby, if you're there, pick up, okay?
Snow?
Oh, thank God. Tell me you found something.
I got it, Snow. Her address was here with Lily's things. It's on, White Plains Avenue, 1284. It's an apartment complex.
Great.
All right, let's go. I don't want to miss him.
I'll meet you there.
All right, I'll see you there.
Bigby! I just got here.
Yeah, me too. It's number 23. I haven't seen it yet.
We're late.
Yeah, I know. This is it.
All right. How do you want to do this? Hear anything?
If anyone's in there, they're being awfully quiet.
Wait. What are you doing?
What does it look like?
Don't just kick it in. We don't know what's on the other side. Let's just save the last resort for last.
Fine, okay. What would you have me do instead?
I don't know. Knock? I mean, we have no idea what's behind this...
Hello?
Hi.
You woke me up.
Sorry about that.
Is something wrong?
Well, pardon the intrusion. I wasn't aware this was a Munchkin's house.
Well, Dorothy, it isn't.
Sharp kid.
Who are you?
Rachel, who are you? Just so...
Well, I'm the sheriff, and this is my partner.
Boss.
Pleased to meet you. How do you do? Is there anything you need?
Is Auntie Greenleaf at home? Does she live here?
You mean my mom?
She ever, make the nightstand levitate, turn frogs into cats, that kind of thing?
Is she a witch, dear?
No, I would never call my mommy that. She treats me all right. Is there... something you want? I don't think I can really help you.
Rachel, do you mind if I take just a quick peek around?
We'll be very quick, and he won't touch anything.
I've been here all night. Nobody's been here. Okay, Sheriff. I'm gonna trust you not to break anything. Don't get me in trouble.
What are we looking for specifically?
Crane. He could still be here. That your mom?
Uh-huh.
What is this?
Mommy uses that to carve her trinkets. It's from the old world.
Trinkets? Like glamours?
not here.
There's no one here but me.
There's nothing that looks like Crane was here either.
Nothing?
See?
The Butcher.
What's that?
A package. Having to do with someone called the Butcher. I saw one just like it at the Tweedle's office. God damn it.
You shouldn't say that.
Nothing.
I keep getting whiffs of that aftershave of his.
I do too.
Can I go to bed now, please?
Is that a glamour tube?
Mommy really doesn't let anyone play with that. Trust me, I've tried. Oh, no, 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 no. Please, 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 just put that back exactly where you found it. No one is allowed to play with
that. It's all right, honey. Bigby's not going to break
it. No, you don't understand. She will freak out if she discovers I've let people in here and let them touch her stuff, okay? She checks all the time to see if things move.
Snow, come on. Are you kidding? It's a glamour tube. Something's going on here.
No! Put it down! Please, don't! This isn't what you think! You gotta believe me! The guy isn't here, I promise!
It's gonna be okay, Rachel.
Please, I'm begging you. I don't wanna get in trouble.
Anti-crane leaf.
It hurts when you do it that fast.
You think we have time to waste on this shit? Think this is some kind of game?
No, I don't. But congratulations on winning it, if that matters to you.
All right, start explaining. And from the beginning.
Where's Crane? Speak quickly.
I ain't a fortune teller, Wolf. I have no heavenly idea where he went to.
You have to know something.
Unless you want a recipe for owl stew.
You're an accomplice to murder. Do you realize that?
You might want to check your facts on that. It doesn't matter. I can't help you. I have no interest in being turned into a skink and crushed under boot heels. There's powers at work here beyond your pathetic authority.
Whatever it is, Greenleaf, whatever it is that's keeping you from saying something, you have to forget it.
You should be a lot more afraid of me than whatever horseshit you think will come back to bite you.
You have no idea what's going on, do you?
Okay, you know what I think? I think we've been more than patient with you. This witch has been selling illegal glamours that continue to undermine everything we've built. She's harboring a fugitive that took advantage of it, and now she's resisting every attempt to make things right. I frankly don't give a crap. If she's afraid for her life, we can at least make sure she never hurts us again. We're destroying the tree.
No! How dare you come in here and threaten to take from me the one thing that... That tree is ancient. It's part of the family, and it's the only thing paying for this shithole apartment. And the Fables, who can't afford the glamours from you, come to me for help. Without them, where do you think they could go?
Don't give me that. You're making money off of other people's misery. Two Fables are dead because of this crap. It's too dangerous leaving this stuff with her.
You think I like being the old woman in these stories? The men are heroes, the ladies are whores, and the old hags like me get to watch everyone they love die.
We have very different ways of handling our fate.
Very different means to handle it, too.
And I don't use it as an excuse to wreck people's lives.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but please, don't do this.
Isn't there another way? She's a witch. Can't she just work for us? That way she'd be official.
You want to reward her for criminal behavior? We can't trust this woman on the 13th floor.
It doesn't matter, because I'd never do it. I'm not a house cat, and I don't play well with others.
Oh, trust me, no one would confuse you for a cuddly animal. Bigby, this is an order. Burn the tree.
No! Look, I'll tell you. Crane was here.
He was here, and he left. He went to the pudding and pie to try to use my ring on the girls over there to get information.
What does the ring do?
He thinks it's the ring of dispel. You know, that it will pierce the protection around the girl's speech. He says pulling the truth out of them will prove his innocence. It won't, though. Damn thing lost its power decades ago.
I'm sorry, but we still can't let you keep the tree. It wouldn't be right after what's happened. Bigby.
Please, Sheriff. Don't.
Today's your lucky day, Greenleaf. I'm hiring you as the business office's newest witch in residence.
But Bigby!
The witches over there will keep her out of trouble. And we have a glamour shortage as it is. It makes the most sense now. And you get to keep your fucking tree.
Just don't expect me to bow down to your little woman here.
Don't think for a second that this is over.
So what? A moving truck's gonna show up here or something?
Something like that.
We'll call you.
No, it's nothing you need to concern yourself with. I don't think so, at least.
Shit.
Hold on. Oh, did you miss a spot? Mr. Clean, come to smash up the rest of my place. Oh, I see. Come to audition, you bitch.
Get out of the way.
Ah, I'm in your way, love.
Tell me what you know, now!
Hey, you can't just go in there. We have a problem.
Tell me who did it! Just tell me who did it! I know you know!
Mr. Crane, please! She can't help!
I know you know what the plan is! I won't be held accountable for this!
Oh my god! Bigby!
Wait, don't!
I didn't do anything! I promise you, I didn't do anything! These girls, the girls, they'll back me up! I just have to get this stupid ring working, that's all! They can't talk because of that spell, but once this ring gets through, I'll know what's going on and this whole thing will be over! That's all, please!
The ring won't work. Greenleaf sold you out.
What? No! This will work! I assure you, it must! I went to... You... Damn you, come on! Please! Tell me who killed her!
My lips are sealed. How many years?
What?
How many years has this been going on?
Too many. But I didn't kill those women, Bigby. Please, I had nothing to do with that. Oh, God.
We found the photos of you and Lily.
I know.
I just love you, Snow. I love you, and I'm sorry I'm not Prince Charming, okay? I'm sorry I didn't cheat on you and run away to Europe.
You don't love me, Crane. I know what this is. I've seen it before. It is not love.
Bigby? I don't think he did it.
What?
Look at him. Do you really think this man murdered these women? He wouldn't be brave enough. Not to put his stamp on the world like that.
We've been chasing this guy. Just... why now?
Because look at him. You said you found evidence of him defrauding Fabletown. Of using our money for his own... ambitions. That's one thing. But don't you have doubts he's a murderer? We've both known him for so long.
I can't believe I'm hearing this.
Did you see how he was acting when you showed up?
Yes, I know how this...
This fuck-up knows more than he's saying.
I don't!
Yes, okay, he probably does. But there's a difference between being involved and being the guy who did it.
Okay, but if Crane didn't kill Faith and Lily, I'm sorry, but who the hell did?
This whole thing is bigger than Crane. He wouldn't have the stones to send the Tweedles after me. Somebody else is involved.
Well, shit.
I didn't intend for any of this to get so...
You've been stealing money from Fabletown for years, haven't you? Yeah. We're not gonna kill you, so quit your shivering. Ichabod Crane, you are under arrest for the misappropriation of Fabletown funds. You have the right to counsel, the right to depose witnesses.
Get the fuck up. Now.
I guess we know who's in charge, Sheriff.
Sometimes it's fuzzy.
You think you have what it takes to run that office? You think I didn't make sacrifices? I made sacrifices. And you won't be in that chair 1 minute before you have to give up something you care about just so the wheels don't fall off the goddamn wagon.
I did the best I could with what I had. And the town took everything it could out of me. If I maybe took a little something back in return, then so be it. Oh, God.
If I were you, I'd keep that trap of yours shut.
What are you saying?
What you got there? Look, it's recently come under our attention that you're, how shall I put this, attempting to claim what is the personal property of the Crooked Man. He's about yay high, 120 odd pounds, pissed his sheets until he was 14. Sound familiar?
I haven't told him anything.
Not now. The grown-ups are talking.
Who are you?
No. That's not how this works. How this works is you are going to walk Crane over here, like a good doggy.
It wasn't my fault.
Shut up. You're interfering with official Fabletown business. Step aside.
Tweedledee, what's the, you know, that thing the Mundys call me?
What?
My nickname. You know what I'm talking about.
Bloody Mary,
that's it. Thank you. And do you know why they call me that? Because some of them, they think it's funny to have their little sleepovers and go into their little bathrooms and say my name 5 times in the mirror. They find it less funny when I actually show up and feed their lungs to the family dog. And I do that for a hobby. Like golf, to relax. This is my job. I like my job.
This was really the wrong day to try and pull this shit.
I told you he'd never just give him up.
Fuck it.
Bigby?
Just didn't know when to end. You know, you didn't think silver bullets would work on anything but a pure werewolf. But as it turns out, it's just what they use. Right, Wolfie? I mean, hey, look, I know it sounds ridiculous, but really, guys, can you argue with these results? Because I know I can't.
Wait! Stop! Just take him, okay? Take Crane. Just stop, please.
Yeah, I don't know.
Just get out of here.
It's your lucky day, kid. The Crooked Man says it's okay with him. Hello, Ichabod. Got a stomach ache? Oh, and just between us girls, Crane ain't no killer. I mean, look at his face. Couldn't stick a pig if his life depended. Thank you.
Nope, not like your boyfriend. Well, this is gonna be a beautiful relationship we have with you guys. Really, I mean it. I'm jazzed about it. Out with the old, in with the new. Long live the queen. I'm sure we'll be in touch. See you around.
He's lucky to be alive. And he won't be next time if he keeps going like this.
This is getting worse by the minute. We don't have time to sit around and wait for their next move.
I'll get things under control.
Woody, I'm not gonna tell you again.
Back off, dog. This doesn't concern you.
What'd you want to talk about?
I just wanted to, about last night.
When people hear what you did to Dom, they're going to think you've gone back to your old ways.
Don't hold out on me, Jack. You've always got some angle.
Not this time. I know when a mark's not worth the trouble. Do you?
Don't make me come down there to deal with you. I don't want it. You don't want it. Then again, you don't have much choice at this point. Do you?